Now folks, I've had quite a few of you ask me about this bridge that's on my layout. Well, for many of you, you'll recognise it as the ground suspension bridge by Hornby. It's been in their range many, many years. This I've had since about 1990, 2000. It's a self-assembly kit, just all clips together. So, I have it all together in about 10 minutes, something like that. Instructions are very easy to follow. It comes with various different sort of self-adhesive brick paper you stick on there and there. But what I've done, however, is modified it by using two pieces of 1 metre long ducting, which the towers you simply just slot into. And what we've done is to secure it on the floor using these fix-it blocks from a local DIY shop. Basically drilled and screwed it to the floor and screwed it the size and both sides there. On the ends, what we've done is we used a bit of 6mm ply that's drilled and secured into the baseboard at the end there, and then the end tower is held in place on these fix-it blocks, which is screwed into the 6mm ply and also into the tower. And to stop the tower from lifting up the ends, we've used these little fix-it blocks, which I've cut in half and I've screwed it to the board, and that little lip there holds it down, so it's pushing down on these end towers. So if you look at it this end, you can actually see it's a slight ramp up, and the same again at the other end. But what we've done is that with the two towers is that they're actually leaning back slightly like that, and it's lifted up the middle part of the bridge, so keeps it level, so when like the heavy locos are going across, it doesn't sag down at all. The other thing I've done is with the track is I've actually drilled into the deck and new track pins to hold it down, so if we get any hot weather should stop any expansion of the track and it lifting. And that folks is basically it. Thanks very much.